I started making games when I was 13 years old. Now I'm 23 and working on my biggest project ever. It's called Ye Old Meme Game 2, and, well, it's insane, but I'll get onto that later. Today I'm going to show you how everything I've done over the past 10 years has allowed me to reach this point in my life, from making successful money-making games, bots, websites, a full-on dating app, and projects from my university degree. There was even a time where PewDiePie played one of my games on his channel. Man, it's been one hell of a journey. So when I was 13, I was really into video games and always wanted to learn to code so I could make my own games. But every time I tried, I would instantly become overwhelmed at all the different concepts these YouTube tutorials were trying to explain. It was just too much for my little monkey brain to understand. But just as I was about to abandon all hope and give up on my game dev dreams, I discovered something that would change the very course of my life forever. A little game engine called Game Salad. So what is Game Salad? Well, it's a game engine that makes it unbelievably easy to create 2D games in just a few days without having to write a single line of code. All you have to do is drag and drop these behavior bubbles over to the right, and you have a working game. This was just what my monkey brain needed. So I started work on my first ever game, Block Runner. It's kind of stupid, you just jump and crouch to avoid these squares, but I thought it was pretty cool at the time. And so I bought an App Store account for $100 so I could publish it and show my friends. Spoiler alert, I got roasted. I didn't care though. Making this game was one of the funnest things I'd ever done, so I made a bunch more silly games just like it. As you can probably tell, I was quite into Batman at the time. Actually, I was so into Batman that I decided to make a dedicated 2D platform game about him. I called it the Batcave, and while it looks terrible, it ended up being my most successful project to date. I made around $150 each month from ad revenue for a good few years. Now I was super invested in game development. 2014 comes along, and there was a phenomenon that would disrupt the entire game dev industry forever. Oh yeah, you know it. Now, having just personally experienced how easy it was for games to make money, I wanted in on this trend. So I remade Flappy Bird and started pumping out clones with different themes. There was Mario Flap, Flappy Batman, Flappy Block, Flappy Face, Flappy Bird on Drugs, Birdie Flap, Flappy Damn Daniel, but most importantly, Flappy Meme, which ended up kind of blowing up, getting 200,000 downloads and making thousands from ad revenue. Little did I know at the time, but Flappy Meme would trigger a chain of events that would lead to something much bigger later on. But for now, I was getting good at developing games, and I was beginning to see the similarities between drag and drop Game Salad and actual coding concepts that I'd once been so afraid of. So now it had been a good couple years since I started making games, and I had a new idea for something I wanted to build, and it wasn't a game. See, I was really into memes at the time, and I thought, why not make a bot that automatically steals memes from other meme pages and posts them on my own meme page? So I did, and struggled a lot at first, but learned quickly by copying and pasting code from YouTube tutorials. And eventually, I made a bot that worked. I even built a system to get me loads of followers by spamming memes in the comments section of other pages so that people would click and come to my page. This worked really well for a while, but then it all came crumbling down when the Cambridge Analytica scandal happened and Facebook removed most of the functionality from their API, which broke all my bots. But hey, at least now I was able to kinda actually code. Although, I was still too scared to code an actual game. So I went back to making games in Game Salad, and this time, some crazy shit went down. My friend at school had asked me to show him how to make a game, so I did. To teach him, I came up with an example project where you're a banana floating in space. Then I went home that day and decided to upload the project to the App Store, cause why not? I didn't think much of it, but then a few months later, something happened.
We have Space Banana. You heard me right, folks. Space Banana.
I couldn't believe it. This was so hype. But also, if PewDiePie would play a random game about a banana in space, then surely if I made a game about PewDiePie himself, he'd play that too. So I got to work and made PewDiePie, a 2D platform game with similar mechanics to the Batcave, but with much more content, levels, and refinement. Unfortunately, PewDiePie never ended up playing the game, but something much funnier happened. I tried publishing the game to Steam by making a greenlight page for the Steam community to vote on, and it got roasted. It was so bad that a YouTuber by the name Jim Sterling made a video on it, and this is what he had to say.
As for this game, well, I don't know, something about it makes me wanna, I guess, set my face on fire.
I don't want to look at any more of it. I hate it. I hate it! I hate it.
Right, well. Let's take a look at the comments. What did we ever do to deserve this? I have no idea if this was made by a fan or a hater. I just really want to see Felix sue this guy. Today feels like a good day to stick knitting needles in my eyes. Oof. Well, whatever. That was funny, and it was character building, but I decided that from now on, I was gonna try and make actual good games. Now in 2015, you may remember a mobile game publisher called Ketchapp becoming really popular. They only published games that were beautiful, simple, and addictive. I thought I should try and make some of my own games for them to publish. My first submission was called Perkren, a simple game where you go through the gaps for as long as possible. I thought it looked good, but Ketchapp rejected it. It was probably too simple, so I tried again, this time with a game called Nometry, where you bounce off the walls to hit the target, kind of like pool. Again, Ketchapp rejected it. So I tried again, with a game called Height of the Hills. Again, Ketchapp rejected it. This time I think it was because it was too complex, but was it the appearance? I tried making my brand look more professional with a cleaner logo and website, and made a game with a new theme where you tap yes or no if the color matches the word. Again, rejected. I tried one last time with a game called Switch Sides where you tap to switch sides to avoid purple stuff and collect orange stuff. And that got rejected too. Maybe I just didn't understand what Ketchapp wanted. Or maybe there was just too much competition from better game developers. Either way, I gave up. Cut my losses, and moved forward with my game dev career. It was time to move on to bigger and better things, and for that, I had to think of my next game idea. Well, at school, during break time, me and my friends would always play this local multiplayer game called Curve Fever. It was only on PC, so I decided I should make a port of the game for iOS and Android. I named it Maneuveration, and it was my most difficult project yet. It saw pretty decent success over its lifetime, getting around 100,000 downloads. The only issue I had was that I copied the idea from another game. It wasn't original. My next game, however, would be the most important and creative game I've ever made. Having seen the success that Flappy Meme got, I wanted to replicate that all over again. So I knew my next game should be about memes. But what would the gameplay actually be? Well, what was I good at? Let's see. I've made a few 2D platform games already, so why not use all the experience I've gained from making those? And that's exactly what I did. Over the next few months, I built out what is now known as Ye Olde Meme Game 1. It was an instant success, getting hundreds of thousands of downloads and quite a few people on YouTube playing the game. The biggest channel who played it was Neat Mike, and this is what he had to say.
Oh my god, I'm just sitting here watching this menu. This is fucking awesome! Let's wreck some scrubs. Holy shit. This is incredible. Collect weed, spliff ammo. This is art. This is the best game I've ever played. I'm crying! I don't know why. It's fucking beautiful. It's fucking beautiful.
Oh my god. Let's take a look at the reviews. This game beat my cancer. This should belong next to the Mona Lisa. I left with a new outlook on life. I have seen the face of God. It gave me something I've not had in a long time. Happiness. My dad came back with the milk the moment this game has been downloaded. My son is very young in pre-K. He's learning bad words from this game. But there was one problem with the game. There just wasn't enough content. There were only 5 short levels in the whole game. The thing is, I'd only ever spent a few months tops working on a single game, which meant I'd never created a full traditional game like what the big boy indie devs had on Steam. I was just some low-tier mobile developer, but the people wanted more from Ye Olde Meme Game, and so a little seed of an idea was planted in the back of my mind. That seed would remain there for the time being while I improved as a developer, but you'll see. For now though, I wanted to try and make a proper full game that was actually professional. I took one of my favourite games from my childhood as an inspiration, added a bunch of new ideas, and gave birth to Toadline, a puzzle game with 20 levels of increasing difficulty. I really polished it down so that I could have at least one game to show off to people without looking like a failed game developer. It only got 20,000 downloads, but it's more of a showcase game to prove I'm actually capable, so I'm happy. Now at this point, I wanted to grow more as a game developer, and Game Salad was just limiting me. I made one final experimental demo game in Game Salad called Text-Based Jimmy, where everything is text and the floor is a super immature storyline, and then I finally decided to move on to Unity. Unity was still too scary though, especially the idea of coding in C#. So I found this visual scripting tool called Playmaker that's halfway between actual coding and Game Salad's drag and drop. Then I made my first ever 3D game, called 2 Cubes, where you tap left or right to move the purple box to avoid red and collect green. It was hard to make, but I learned a lot about Unity. My next Unity project was a laggy ass game called Vaporwave Simulator that's essentially just a museum of vaporwave artifacts that you walk around and look at. This time, I actually coded the basic movement controls in C#. I uploaded the game to Steam and made $1,000 in 2 days, and then the game died and made no money after people realized it was terrible and review bombed it. Oh well. I was now at the point in my life where school was over and university was about to start. I'd got into Imperial College London to do electronic and information engineering, and I thought it would be a good idea to get a head start and do my own coding project. I stumbled upon an API offered by Amazon that matches similar looking faces together, and I had an idea. An app that lets you find and talk to your doppelganger. So I started making the app in Xcode, and midway through development, something just clicked in my mind. I suddenly understood everything about coding. This burst of coding euphoria ended up causing so much feature creep that I ended up accidentally making a full-on dating app where you find people who look similar to other people you find attractive. I learned so much about databases, client-server interaction, and cloud services, and got good at writing code for huge-scale projects like this. The app, which I called Jecto, ended up taking a good 2 years to complete, well into my uni degree, and when I released it, it didn't get many downloads because there were just too many features, but at least now I'd become a god at programming and was way ahead of my peers at uni. Throughout uni, I coded a bunch of uni-related and personal projects that really leveled up my coding ability. We made a C compiler, got taught about assembly language, CPUs, and computer architecture, all the way up to machine learning, networking, and robotics. My friend and I also made a couple startups, like portosaurus.com to build and host a portfolio for you, and downloadasaur.com, a reliable YouTube downloader website with no ads that I still use when editing my videos. I made YouTube Word Finder, which is a desktop app that finds clips of YouTubers saying certain words so you can make videos of them singing. I made MenuBar.doc, which is a macOS app that shows your dock of apps in the menu bar to free up screen space and reduce lag. And for my final year project, I made a web app called SpoonFeed, which helps students collaborate through forums, group chats, and module reviews. All these projects taught me how to approach literally any software project I could think of, but now is where that seed that was planted earlier in my mind started to sprout. Up until now, Ye Olde Meme Game 1 was my most popular game, and it was the most fun I'd had developing something. The only problem was, people were begging for more levels to be added. I could have gone back and just added more, but I just couldn't downgrade back to that super basic drag and drop game engine. So I decided to make a brand new sequel to the game using Unity. Thing is though, I didn't want to be constantly designing loads of new levels to keep you guys happy. I personally prefer actually building the game itself. So what if I didn't have to make the levels? What if you guys could make the levels instead? And I just provide a system for you to do so? Then there would be an endless supply of levels created by the community for the world to play, kinda like Mario Maker. This was a huge realization, and by far the most ambitious project I'd ever dreamed up. But, with all my experience, I was confident I could do it, and got to work. And after 3 years of on and off grinding, I completed the level builder and an online level sharing system, which I made a full video about on my channel. I'm still working on the game, and all that's left to do is to add loads more memes to the game. In fact, a couple weeks ago, I sent the alpha version of my game to my Discord community. You guys made some hilarious levels, and I made a video where I played some of them. But here we are now. I'm developing the rest of the game on this channel, and I even livestream it. A lot of the ideas for the game are suggested by you guys, so if you join the community early on, you can be part of something great, something that future generations can look back on to learn about our culture today. So like this video, subscribe, and I'll see you soon.